Hello everyone and welcome to my geography class. In this class we are going to see about the third chapter. In the third chapter we are going to talk about our changing earth. So for this particular class I request to all the cadets to please have a notebook and a pen to copy down the important points. So I welcome you to my geography class. In this class we are going to have the third chapter. So the third chapter, the name of the chapter is our changing earth, topic number 1, lithospheric plates. In the chapter number 3 we will talk about our changing earth, topic number 1, lithospheric plates. We will see about how our lithospheric plates are formed and how their movement is there and the reason why they are moving from one place to another. Second point we will talk about the movement of our earth. What we will discuss? We will talk about earth movement. How the earth movement is here and we will continue with this topic. So the chapter number 1, in that we talked about our environment. Chapter number 2 we talked about inside of the earth. Now the chapter number 3 which is talking about our changing earth. So in that we will see lithospheric plates and earth movement. So let's proceed to have the lithospheric plates. So what are lithospheric plates and how they are making the changes? For that purpose I want to show you one chart which make you to be easier to understand about that. See this chart. This chart is speaking about changing phase of earth, prithvi ka badalta swaroop. So in that some agents are there and the agents are glacier, then the groundwater, wind, then the sea water and the river water. So how these agents are changing the phases of earth, we are going to look all these agents which are responsible for the changing phases of the earth in this chapter, one by one. So next, moving further to discuss about the lithospheric plates. Now you are observing this, a cup and a saucer. Then, this is saucer. So in your mind there will be one question about that, why sir is showing the cup and saucer? It's a tea time? Yes, it's a tea time. Certainly not. It's a cup and saucer and this is only a saucer. If I am going to hold this saucer in my hand like this and if I am going to leave it, so what is going to happen? So the saucer is going to dash to the floor and it's going to break into pieces. So my question to you, so it is going to break into how many pieces? So now the question and its answer is in your mind. It will break into 2 pieces, 3 pieces, 4, 5, 6, 7. So like that, if I am going to hold this type of saucer in my hand, if I am going to leave it, the saucer is going to dash to the floor and it is going to break into number of pieces. They are 2, 3, 4 and many can be there. After that, why the saucer is breaking into number of the pieces? Here the point is there. So, due to the force and due to the pressure, it's going to break into number of pieces. Likewise, in the same one, earlier there was a huge landmass and that landmass from inside of the earth and outer forces due to the heat, pressure, forces. So, they started to scatter. So that Ganga scattered and different landforms have all the continents are there. So they scattered. So that is one of the examples which I want to place in front of you to show about that how this lithospheric plates are moving very slowly. And the reason why they are moving, we will look into the upcoming slides. So here is the lithospheric plates. So you can see about that, this is it. So these lithospheric plates, they used to move. And how they are moving, we will see. First, we will go to understand about what are lithospheric plates. Next, this is the whole world. As I stated to you, the example of the saucer is breaking like that. Earlier, these all continents were joined together, called as mantle. According to the theory of plate tectonics, it has been divided the whole earth crust, the lithospheric plates, into seven major plates. So here is an Indo-Australian plate, African plate, Eurasian plate, then South American plate, North American plate, and Pacific plate. So these plates are there. These dotted boundaries are marking the plate boundaries. So our idea is here, it's coming into Indo-Australian plate. This line, which is dotted line, is moving here. This is the Indo-Australian plate. So in that, our India is lying. So these plate tectonic theory is speaking about our earth. On that, the lithosphere is there. So lithosphere is divided into number of plates. So how these plates? So in your mind, the question will be there: is really our plate is there inside the ground? So yes, these are moving, and how they are moving and what's there. So taking to you into the flashback, we studied about our earth is there, so crust is there, mantle is there, and core is there. So core also divided into two parts, that's outer and inner. And we also find about that the molten magma, and that molten magma is making these all the plates to slowly move. All these things are described in the plate tectonic theory, which you are going to learn and understand when you will move into the 9th standard. So here we are going to talk and discuss about the plate tectonic and how the formation of all these plates is there. So moving further, in this presentation we will talk about only the lithospheric plates and how the lithospheric plates are formed. Moving to the next. What are lithospheric plates? So lithospheric plates are, the earth crust consists of several large and some small rigged irregularly plates, slabs, which carry continents and ocean floor. As in our previous chapter, already we learned about the continents and ocean floor, which we are talking about the crust and oceanic floor. So let's please, this definition is very important, which is talking about this meaning of lithospheric plates. So what are lithospheric plates? So the earth crust consists of several large and small. So large, which I shown to you, the seven major plates, and our India is lying in Indo-Australian. Moving to the next, the lithosphere is broken into number of plates known as lithospheric plates. So here the answer of the question, what are lithospheric plates? So lithospheric plates are, the lithosphere is broken into a number of plates. So number of the plates means to into number of pieces, and that are called as lithospheric plates. Next, you will be surprised to know that these plates move around very slowly, just a few millimeters each year. So per year they are moving only millimeters. And how they are moving? So the answer is very clear. First, lithospheric plates. What are lithospheric plates? The lithosphere, which is broken into number of pieces, large pieces, small pieces, they are called as plates, and which is called as lithospheric plates. And how they are moving per year, very millimeters. So the answer is, this is because of the movement of the molten magma inside the earth. This is because of the molten magma. If the molten magma is there, so molten magma, and on that the earth crust is there. So that earth crust, this layer crust is moving because the molten magma is there. Next, lithosphere broken into number of pieces. and that is called, going to be called as plates, which are known as lithospheric plates, and these are moving every year very few millimeters, and the reason why, because of the molten metal. So here I don't think about any doubt is there how the lithospheric plates are slowly moving, because inside the earth the molten magma is there, so the plates are moving. Okay, next, the molten magma inside the earth move in a circular manner as shown in the activity. So where is that activity? That is on the next slide. So by this activity we will understand about that, how the molten magma inside the earth move in a circular manner. So moving to the next slide to see about the activity which make us to understand about how the molten magma inside the earth move in a circular manner. Next, take a small colored paper palette, that means a paper ball, right, and put it in a beaker half filled with the water. Place the beaker on a tripod stand and heat it. So that's the example here. So paper ball pellet here, the tripod is there and a heater is here. And as the water is going to be heated, warms, you will observe that the paper pellet is moving upward. The paper pellet is moving upward. And as the warm layer of the water then shrink, as the warm layer of the water is going to be cool, it's going to be come down. In that same manner, so the layers of the water, when they are warm, so it's moving up. When it's cool, it's coming down. The molten magma inside the earth move in a similar manner. So like that only, when the it's heats up, so the paper pellet is going to move up due to the layers, it's cooled down, then again it's coming down. So it's coming and down. So this example is that to show about how the molten magma, here the molten magma, and these are the lithospheric plates. Next, the movement of this plate causes changes on the surface of the earth. So here is the point starting of the chapter, our changing earth, how our earth inside and outside they are changing. So changes, what are the changes due to these plates? So these plates are sometimes coming together, going in a different direction. So like that we are having different changes and different motions of this in the direction, convergent, divergent, then transform, like that. The earth movement are divided on the basis of the forces which cause them. So here the second topic starts, earth movement, and which are divided by the force which is applied to them and the formation of that. The forces which act in the interior of the earth are called as endogenic forces. So here we are seeing endogenic forces, the forces interior, the word interior is important. Interior force causes endogenic forces. Then the same and the forces that work on the surface of the earth, that means outside, they are called as exogenic forces. So here we will discuss about more about endogenic forces and exogenic forces. First, go to the word origin we will see. So here, the word origin is here. In that word, indo means inside, exo means outside. If indo is going to be added to genic, that means the origin. So, endogenic forces. Then, exo, origin, that means genic, exogenic. So, the forces which are insidely, so endogenic. The forces which are outside, they are called as exogenic forces. Due to the two forces, endogenic and exogenic, so many land evaluation is happening on the earth. So let's move to see that. So earth movement, in that topic we will see about how the two forces, endogenic and exogenic forces, are making the earth movement. In which way? Let's see. This is the flow chart, figure number 3.1, from the textbook only I have taken for you. Evaluation of the landform, how the evaluation of the evolution of the landform is there. So that evolution of the all the landforms, earth movement, endogenic forces, exogenic forces, this flowchart is very important. Endogenic forces, exogenic forces, endogenic forces, the sudden forces, and in that sudden forces, what are there? Earthquake is there, volcano is there, landslide there, and many more. Then destructive forces. So this destructive forces, in that the building of mountain, the formation of the mountain. So these destructive forces are creating the formation of the mountain and other features. In that exogenic forces, erosional and depositional features done by river, then wind, then sea waves and glacier. So we will talk and discuss about this flow chart 1.1 earthquake, volcano, landslide, river, wind, sea waves, glacier, all these things one by one in upcoming presentation. So I request all the students to this flow chart is very important to talk about the earth movement. So earth movement, what is that? So you have to see the earth movement and you have to see this flow chart, what is doing. So endogenic forces, what they are doing, exogenic forces, what they are creating. Moving to the next. Endogenic forces sometimes produce sudden movement, and that sudden movement, and other time they are slow movement. So endogenic forces sometimes sudden movement and slow movement. In the slow movement, building of mountain. In a sudden movement, earthquake, volcano, landslide. So sudden movement like earthquake, volcano causes mass destruction over the surface of the earth. As you all know about that, due to earthquake, within a minute or a second, there is a huge destruction. With the volcanoes also, there is a huge mass destruction. Next, we are going to see the overview of this chapter, what we have learned in this particular chapter. So chapter number 3, in that the first point chapter is talking about the overview, what we learn. So we talk the lithospheric plates. So what are lithospheric plates? We have seen the earth crust consists of several large and small ring irregularly shaped plates which carry continents and the ocean floor. They are called as lithospheric plates. Next, these plates move every year within each other, and the reason why? Because of the molten magma inside the earth is moving in a circular way. The next, we talk and discuss about endogenic and exogenic forces, which are the part and parcel of earth movement. The earth movement, in that we have seen the endogenic forces and exogenic forces. Endogenic forces means they are acting inside the earth, and exogenic forces, the forces that work on the surface of the earth. So here in this overview, we have seen about what are lithospheric plates. We have seen about how the theory of plate tectonics making us to understand how our whole earth and its lithosphere is scattered into different plates, and this movement of these plates outside and inside are the responsible formation of different physiographic features. So moving to the homework part. Today, what homework you have to do? So in the notebook, what you are going to do, I'm just going to show you the next slide. Homework part. In this homework part, you are going to write about, define the following term. As I stated to you, what are exogenic forces, what are endogenic forces, and what are lithospheric plates. So endogenic forces, exogenic forces, which are working outside on the surface of the earth, endogenic inside the earth, and lithospheric plates, what are they? Then draw the flowchart of the evolution of the landform. So that flowchart which I have shown to you, the earth movement, and that said the endogenic forces and exogenic forces, that flowchart you have to draw in the notebook. So please copy down this homework. I will give you few seconds to copy down this one. The homework part, define the term exogenic forces, endogenic forces. lithospheric plates. Then the last second question is draw the flowchart of the evolution of the land form. So here in this presentation we have seen about how our earth is changing and the reason responsible behind it. So I request each one of you to please do this homework part and please draw this flowchart. In the examination the flowchart can come for 5 marks. Draw and label the flowchart of diagram of the evolution of the landforms. The next, lastly, here I lastly thank to each and everyone for watching this video and getting benefited. Stay safe and stay healthy. Jai Hind.